Hello again, and welcome to premiere draft of Ravnica Allegiance. So, okay, pick one has interesting options. There are actually several cards I don't mind first picking. Low Mage's Binding, although it's an Azorius card and locks you into kind of two colors, you can still splash this in Simic, you can splash this in Orzo. Grotesque Demise is a fine removal spell, Blade Juggler is a fine creature, Spire Mangler and Ministrant of Obligation are fine choices as well. So I think the options I really want to pick from here are, this is the creature. I wouldn't be picking these other creatures. I could pick the Ministrant. It's a very nice afterlife effect. For 3 mana you get a nice package of stats. And then the Grotesque Demise and Low Mage's Binding. I mean, this is the better removal, but this is requires two colors, so it's one of these three, and I think I'm gonna take the Ministrant in this case. I think it's just such a nice, you know, set of abilities. I mean, well, not a set of abilities, but set of stats that card, you know, gives in the end. Right, someone actually took an uncommon over the Unbreakable Formation. This is quite okay if you have like a... I guess if you have three creatures in play, then you can have a very nice attack, because this will, they will gain also vigilance, so they will be able to block as well. I would pick the Oath of Enforcer here pretty happily too, but I'm obviously gonna take the Unbreakable Formation here. I think it's not even close. I wonder what uncommon did they pick over this. So I would be looking to draft either Orzhov or Azorius based on my first two picks. And this pack at least doesn't really make me want to switch that plan. I mean, the Zyrtar Goblin is of course excellent 2-drop, 2-mana 3-3, and of course later in the game you can push for 2 hasty damage if that's more valuable than having a 3-3, but it's not good enough for me to abandon these cards. So it could be the Senate Griffin here. This is a quite weak pack otherwise. I mean, the Black White is good, but I think if I take the Griffin, I'm still open to both Azorius and Orzhov, so but 4-mana 3-2 flyer isn't that great, but the Scry one helps a bit. It's slightly better than it without the Scry, of course, but I mean, it is not an insignificant ability to Scry for one card, so I think I'm taking the Griffin now. And it doesn't seem like the blue is particularly open in here. But then we have a final payment, which is of course sometimes pretty harsh cost of sacrificing a creature or enchantment or paying 5 life, but you can always play one final payment. This is also a splashable one, so if for some reason blue starts to be open here, I can still, you know, go Azorius and maybe consider splashing this if I get a couple of guild gates that enable it. But yeah, that's really the peak from this pack pretty easily. And I'm looking to draft Orzhov based on my picks now. Although there is the Knight Arbiter, which I'm quite a big fan of. I mean, maybe it's not that good, but 5 mana, I mean, it's only deals 2, but it has vigilance. It's also a very efficient blocker. So that's the thing. This can always go for attack for 2, and then it blocks pretty nicely. So I'm actually taking the Knight Arbiter in here. The other cards are not that great. And I mean, the Vindictive Vampire would probably be my pick for the Orzhov deck, but I'd rather see if I can get this Azorius stuff after all. Although it doesn't seem like that's gonna necessarily happen, but we'll see. Here it's going to be, I guess, Noxious Grudion. This is a the Locket's just not such a great one. I don't want to have this kind of 5-drop. I already have one 5-mana card here. I'm going to take the Grudion in case I'm ending up at Orzhov after all. Okay, now I can take the Guildgate, although the Arrester's Admonition isn't really bad one either. If I'm going to go for Azorius, I do want to take the Guildgate and the Arrester's Admonition. Both are fine choices there. I guess I'll take the Guildgate for now. I want to make sure I have enough of them. And well, I take another Guildgate now. I mean, I suppose I could splash for the Knight Arbiter, although I'm not sure if that is really a card you splash. Anyway, Concordia Pegasus might be what I want here. This is not, it's a 3 mana 2/3. I'm not so happy about that, but I can take the flyer. I know this guild gate would help me splash for the final payment, but I think I just want to take a 2-drop because I don't have those. At least not yet. Okay, but this is a 2-drop I can play. The Scry 2 is actually makes this 2-1 relevant even later in the game. And here is gonna be the trick, I think. So I guess I kind of put the black cards away and try to see if I could go Azorius. But I do remember I have this picked, so if I get something good from black, I can still switch the colors, because I really have only two blue cards here, but also I do have the Azorius guild gates, which make me want to draft blue definitely. Okay, so getting the packs here. Soon I get all the rest of the packs. Okay, another Grudion here. If I am gonna go Azorius of Hasda Officer, yeah, this is just bad. I guess I can play that 3-2. I'm not happy about it, but I can play it. Okay, Skargon Hellkite. Oh boy. Oh boy. That is a good card, but I don't think I can pick it because, I mean, Boros is not even a guild here, so I can't really. It's gonna be very tough to utilize my earlier picks. I mean, I have a couple of these black ones, so I could go Rakdos here, but it's not gonna happen. I mean, I'm just not gonna pick it. On the other hand, this Code of Constraint is fine. I think slightly better than the Arrestor's Admonition. And this ain't a bad 2-drop either, but I think I'm gonna take the code here, and I'm gonna pass this dragon to someone who better get, you know, is better suited for its colors. Well, there is a Mortify and not much anything else that I'm interested in. So this definitely means that I'm gonna pick the Mortify, I'm gonna play the final payment, and I'm going to pick Orders of Guild Gates and maybe even a Locket if it comes to that, because I want to play these two high quality removal spells, absolutely. Okay, Low Mage is binding. The High Alert and Dovin's Equity are pretty nice ones too. Okay, so they're actually in the same uncommon kind of run, appears next to each other, at least in some cases. So I don't think I'm exactly a High Alert deck. So I'm gonna, and this is always a fine pick, but I mean the Law Mage is binding, you can read it. It's a pacifism variant, but it has flash, and it also, well, actually it's an arrest variant because it prevents the use of activated abilities as well. So yeah, I'm gonna pick it. Someone gets the skewer after the dragon, pretty nice. And well, there is a Skitter Eel. There's another Knight Arbiter though, but the Skitter Eel is it's a fine pick. I mean, it doesn't have to be Simic. You can play this in Azorius as well, but I think I'll just take the Knight Arbiter in here. I mean, maybe I get the, you know, the thing back that makes me, lets me, you know, come on, that makes my creatures deal damage based on their toughness. That would be pretty nice with the Knight Arbiters. But here we have an interesting decision. I could just take the Sphinx's Insight. I guess I could take the Azorius Guild Gate, and I could take the Grotesque Demise, but I don't have the lands that enable my splash, so I'm not really that keen on, you know, picking yet another black card. I think I'll just take the card draw spell here this time. Sentinel's Mark is good. You can kind of surprise win a combat, and then you have a permanent upgrade for your creature, or sometimes you just, you know, get some extra life by playing this on in the main phase when you know that some of your guys is gonna be able to attack profitably. But I think it's time to pick the Horse of Guildgate now, because I do want to splash this good quality removal spells, so I'm gonna take the guildgate that helps me do that. Wow, Senate Guildmage, it's one of the better ones because both of these are so cheap to use, I mean, and they are relevant things to do. You want to loot occasionally, and you definitely, you often will have one mana that you can use to just randomly gain two life, and that really is great. I've actually passed a lot of these. I would want to play these, but there's just always been something I've picked over it. But I'm gonna take definitely the Senate Guildmage. That's of course a pretty obvious pick. Now I would take the Oath of Guildgate, but there's a Sphinx of New Prague, however you say this Prague. So yeah, I'll take it. I'm a bit sad to pass this, but this is a great card. Now finally I'm gonna play the pick the Arrestor's Admonition, so let's take it now. There's no high alert here, sadly, but I'm gonna take the guildgate because of course this blue-blue-white-white thing really wants me to, I want to have access to a lot of mana fixing when I have this kind of spell in my deck. No, this is the high alert pack, so yeah, I mean this assess combat damage equal to, yeah, you can't really choose, you have to do it like that. Problem is that I have also creatures that have higher power than toughness, so it's actually gonna be a drawback at in some cases, which makes me want to just pick that one. Oh, well, it would be very good with this one though. But yeah, I'm taking the Senate Courier here regardless, but I don't think the high alert was the correct pick to make. I don't care about the knight, but the Grotesque Demise came back, so I might as well pick it. Oh, this came back too. I actually have more playables than... Okay, it might just be that I'm not gonna splash for that black. You know, I might have enough good Azorius cards in here. Of course, I have 5 lands in here, so that's 21 playables, but I will see about that. Anyway, here it's gonna be another Sphinx. This is a rare and counterspell and all, but this is still a 3 mana counterspell. Yeah, you gain 3 life, but counterspells aren't really that great. However, this kind of a big flyer with Vigilance and the ability that makes it harder to opponent to remove it is definitely the pick I'm gonna make. And with all these guild gates I have, the mana cost shouldn't be that much of a problem. A Bellhaunt. There's a Gate Colossus with this many gates, it might actually be something I wanna play, but there's also yet another Night Arbiter. I mean, this is of course a very good one. I will have like maybe... Well, I don't know really. I mean, it could be just safer to pick the Night Arbiter and kind of... Sometimes you don't draw the gates and this is a very expensive card. Yeah, I'll just take the Night Arbiter in here. So how about this? Another Sphinx is inside or another Guildgate. I mean, I might just take the Guildgate here. I mean, which sounds pretty stupid now that I just did pass the Gate Colossus, but I mean I have a double of these things. I do want to make sure I can actually get my mana fixed here. I mean the Sphinx's inside is a 4 mana draw 2, it's not that great, so I'm gonna take the Azorius Guildgate here, and I probably won't be playing that those black cards, I mean especially because I get yet another low mage's binding here. I think I have enough removal, so I'm gonna just cut the black here and see how the deck looks. So this is like 5 guild gates, it's 21 cards here. Yeah, I think it's gonna be fine. How about this? That's not great. 4 mana ability, it's not good. How many creatures I have? Only 12. So okay, I need to just take some random creature, I think. Civic Stalwart maybe. Yeah, let's take it. I need some cheap stuff actually. Cheap creatures preferably, but doesn't happen here. Well, the Summary Judgment is fine. Removal. Yeah, okay, I wouldn't be having that many creatures here, but I suppose I can live with that. So the Forbidden Spirit is probably the peak here. I don't need 4 drops as much as I need cheaper cards. And the double caster mana cost is not an issue when I have 5 guild gates in here. Now those guild gates will mean that I'm not gonna be able to play things on curve all the time, because I will play tapped lands here on turns when I would have needed the mana from the land, but it's something I can live with. Another admonition, could consider running it rather than the Shimmer of Possibility. Yeah. And again, this is like a this is best of one, so I'm not gonna play this kind of stuff. I'm not gonna play any of those. The 3-2 is of course quite weak as well. Hasta officer, I can play it. This is not exciting. I'll take the 3-2 here. This at least has something other than the just the you know the it has a, some additional ability. Here I'll just take the uncommon. I'm not gonna play all those. Okay, so draft seems to be over. So if you don't know about my channel, I do upload daily draft videos. So please consider subscribing if you want to keep in touch in that in sort of way. Yep. Let's just cut the cards. I will have the. I suppose I'm just gonna play 4 and 4 each of basic lands here. So let's add the lands here. Let's take something cool. This is from Ravnica, right? 4 of those and 4 of those. That's the mana there. 17 lands, 5. No, actually, what did I say? Of course, I meant 8 and 8, right? No, I can't count apparently. 6 and 6. That's what I meant. 6 and 6. That gives me 17 lands. And I have 11 sources for both. So these double casters shouldn't be, or should I say double casters, shouldn't be a problem at all. And here is the deck before cuts. 16 creatures. I can cut something, but I don't know if I want to cut that many guys. I think I'm actually liking the Watchful Giant in here because I have all these flyers and these unblockable guys, so I might want to have this kind of a 6 toughness creature, which is of course very, you know, not a good attacker. 6 mana and 3 power is very bad, but it's a very good blocker thanks to the token it also gives. So I can win with my flyers and these unblockable guys and then just have this kind of blocker there. So I really don't have any 2-drop creatures other than these 3, and I don't think I passed them that much. I guess the one card that I passed was the 2-mana 2-2 that gains a life when a creature enters battlefield on your side of the board. But I mean that was like pack 1, pick 1, pack 2, pick 1 or something like that, where there was a better card I definitely wanted to choose over it. So Arrester's Admonition, I can cut like 1 immediately. And maybe even a second one. That's out of the interaction spells, it's probably the worst. I think I might want to run the 1 mana +2/+2 here. I might need to have access to cheap tricks in here because I have a pretty, you know, heavy mana curve in here. 3 5 drops and 1 6 drops, and also a bunch of 4 drops. So I think I'm gonna keep that one. And I think I'm gonna cut one of these admonitions again, and then okay. Well, there's still cuts to make. I think it could be the Civic Stalwart. Yeah, I have here. Yeah, I don't need a 4 mana 3/3, and this +1/+1 ability isn't necessarily the greatest in here. I have 3 4 mana creatures and then the card draw spell, so that made sense. And then I think I'm gonna cut. I have here 15 creatures. Maybe I'll just cut the officer. It's not really that great either. How many 3-drop creatures I have here? 1, 2, 3, 4 of them. And then a lot of other stuff that I can do with 3 mana. So I think those were the cuts. Color balance is, well, evenish. There's no reason to tweak the amount of basic lands. And this is going to be it. Let's see how the games go. Well, this is certainly a good hand. I have one of my few 2-drops. And some interaction, and if I draw 1 blue source, I can play the Sphinx too. Okay, petitioners, should I be scared? To activate an... Okay, this is just a one card mill. No win. That's gladly not the best of planeswalkers, but when they have a turn two... when they have a turn two, 1-3... It's gonna be a bit tougher. I mean, I basically have to use the Law Mage's Binding on the petitioners because I at least force them to jump block with the Thopter token. That is... Because otherwise I don't have any reasonable attack here. This doesn't work on other than tapped creatures. Yeah, that's actually what I have to do here. I need to try to pressure the Dovin. I don't want it to create a ton of 1-1s. This also makes it unable to mill, so it, I mean, I don't have to worry about that. I mean, yeah, but it can't use any activated abilities. But if they have something that to deal with the guild mates or block it, okay, at least they have to tap an extra land, so they would have to have some kind of 2-mana blocker or interaction spell, or they're just gonna have to. Okay, they're gonna just have to jump block it again, which is fine enough that I drew the island. And I don't have more than 6 islands in the deck. And it's the only card that actually makes me able to cast the Sphinx here. That was a very lucky thing. I hope they don't have a quench. They could have a quench. Thanks. That would have been super annoying. So now the Dovin isn't gonna do anything, and the opponent also just conceded. I mean, they were at 22 life. They had 5 cards, 3 colors, 4 mana at least. I wasn't really winning that quickly, but I guess they just didn't like the fact that they didn't get any value out of the Dovin there. Okay, so, alright, I'm gonna keep it, but you know, 2-5 drops, 1-6 drop, not exactly ideal, but I have a looter in here, I can get rid of those expensive cards if I need to. And now that I have the Sphinx of Nibra, that's actually gonna be pretty nice. Yeah, I'm gonna do it right away, I'm gonna loot here. I'm gonna get rid of one of the, I mean, the Watchful Giant here, that it's more important that I hit my land drops. Now next turn I have the new buff coming up, so that's gonna be nice. It's gonna, yeah, okay, this is ideal now. I can actually have a free attack in here, so let's do it. And then play the Sphinx here. So this is pretty sweet. I have 2 unblockable guys, and they really can't really easily raise me now. Oh, that was a nice one for them, because now my Sphinx can... let me see. I mean, do I have to actually... I could Law Mage's Binding the Senate Courier here, and I can start hitting for damage here. That's an interesting thing, because this Forbidden Spirit isn't just gonna do anything. Of course, if they have another flyer blocker, then it's just... But I'm gonna do it anyway. I'm going to do it anyway. And I guess I'm not gonna... Well, let's see what they do. I can decide to loot or gain 2 life, because the Forbidden Spirit might be just quite useless. Yeah, I mean, it's gonna be a 1-4 here, there, so I'm gonna loot the Forbidden Spirit away here. The 3-3 isn't gonna do much. Of course, if I draw like a land, I'm gonna discard that, but I didn't, and now I have a couple of these things. Do I want to attack and trade with the Spirit of the Spires? Let's first see if they have a counter spell for this thing. Well, they did. So now they don't have any mana for any kind of a trick. Do I want to trade here? I lost my trick here, so I can't really... This combat will never be that amazing for me. I guess I'm gonna trade here. And I have the looter, but I do want to have access to 6 mana, because I will be playing these guys, and I want to use the Senate Guildmage here too. Okay, so this is now a race of... I do have the life gainer, which is actually very relevant here. So I'm gonna be gaining life here now. So this race will be super easy for me, unless they have a high alert, which they of course could, given the card choices in their deck. Yeah, they are very likely to have high alert, because this is also amazing with the high alert. What did I lose? Some irrelevant cards. Okay, don't care about that at all. This thing has Vigilance, so the Summary Judgment won't do anything to it. Has Defender and loses Flying. Okay, but it really... Doesn't the opponent understand that? It doesn't do anything when it... No, actually, it has Defender. Oh yeah, it can... Was there something else, something different that... Oh, come on, do they have... okay, I guess I just lost the game. What? They had the... Oh man, that was sick. They had the counter spells for 2 of my Azorius Knight Arbiters and the removal for the 3rd one. Okay, I guess sometimes you just can't... Wow, that was... Oh, I pressed the wrong... I was supposed to loot there, whatever. Oh man, this is just insane. This is just insane. Okay, at least I have that. So, what does that mean? I'm gonna... Gonna bounce my Knight Arbiter here. And I guess I'm gonna Summary Judgment the Orator instead of the 1-3 Flyer here. But yeah, I'm a bit disgusted that they happen to have exactly all this stuff. Okay, to deal with my guys, but at least I got to bounce my guy, and let's hope they don't have another Thought Collapse there. So let's do it like this now. And I can gain life again. Can play the Hunter Officer. Okay, so I have a chance now again. So first I will do this, get to boost this guy a bit. And then I will attack for 3 and... I don't even think I'm gonna play there. A Ministrant, because I just rather gain 2 life. This don't do anything here. At least not yet. It will be good when I attack it, so that I will get the tokens perhaps, and then I can use the Unbreakable Formation there, but... I mean, they have also milled me enough that I'm not supposed to loot anymore. I have only 8 cards left in the deck. So, what to do here? That this thing taps a creature, doesn't untap its controllers. So what does that mean? It does mean, I think, that I'm going to... I do want to have the Sentinel's Mark on my 3-2 instead of this guy, because then I can attack with this being a 4-4. I'm just thinking about how should I do that turn. I could also play the Ministrant. No, actually I'm gonna do it like this now. Let's tap that guy. Then I can attack with the Hasta Officer here. And I'm gonna play the land just because I'm definitely not gonna loot anymore. I don't wanna get milled. So, I mean, I guess I could attack with the Senate Guild Mage as well. And I will. I don't care about gaining that life there, I don't think. Maybe I should care about it. No, I don't care about it. Sadly, they had the correct blocks in there. Would have been nice to get rid of the courier there. But now I will have a 4 power ground guy. And this thing will be tapped for one turn, and then I can play. I can make it the 5-5 with the unbreakable formation. Yep, so I'm going to attack with all these. No, it doesn't make sense to attack with the guildmates. They're just going to block it. Okay, that's annoying. I just... Yeah, I mean, it looked so good when I had the 3 Knight Arbiters, and they were able to deal with them all. So let's say I lose my unbreakable formation here now. So, I mean, I can make it. It just doesn't make any sense. I mean, I should just, you know, lose this guy after all. Because it doesn't do anything anymore, because if I save it with the formation, that simply means that they are gonna have a 2-5 blocker for it. So yeah, let's let that guy go and... Man, that was annoying. Well, I don't know about if I should be looting or not. I will decide later on. Well, there's the high alert. I mean, of course. Of course there is the high alert. Yeah. So they're gonna deal now 12 and I'm gonna lose. Can't block any of them. I can gain 2 life. Well, I mean, that was just a... What can you do here? I think I did everything I could. It just wasn't enough this time. Okay, I get to scry 2 on turn 2, so I should be able to curve out somewhat nicely in here. Well, unless they have like a quench for this, because they are on the play, and so they will have 2 mana before me. Opponent also is either away from the keyboard or just really thinking about whether they should mulligan or not. Well, this is boring. Just skip the video forward a bit so you can actually see when something is happening. Okay, so they now got the timer, and I didn't lose my connection. I did check it already that I am not the one who is out of sync in here, or at least I shouldn't be. basically when that timer goes runs out, then they will simply keep the hand, and then it's gonna be my decision to keep or not. Which I do, and now I need to wait for another timer to go. But I don't know if it's gonna auto concede right away if they really don't do anything here. Because I think the game lets you auto, you know, pass like once, but then it should be, I think, forcing the concede. Of course, in this case, they don't even have any time out, so. Well, I don't know. This must be very interesting for you guys. Yeah, I'm not really sure if I'm gonna get a turn here or are they just gonna blow up right now. Well, that's a free win. Most likely. Yep. So you can just skip to the next round from the chapter selection. Well, this is fine. I don't have the double white for the Forbidden Spirit, but I do have five planes and five guild gates, so that means 10 sources for white mana. By the way, is this opponent... I mean, they can't be the same opponent, right? I don't remember their alias. Okay, at least now there's some game going on. But anyway, even though I don't have the double caster mana, I do have the Hasta officer coming up. And I can play something. If they would have played something, I could have played the Summary Judgment there. But they didn't have a 2-drop either. And now that... Yeah, I don't want to waste the plus one, so I can just play this and... This ability won't do anything, and they might have a removal spell for it. They did not. Senate Griffin, okay. So I think I'm gonna... I mean, the mana efficient way to do things would be to play the Sphinxes inside right now. But I'm going to add to the board instead. I think it makes more sense. I mean, that does mean that they scry to top, by the way. I just want to play the creature here. I think it's just more better idea for the tempo. I might not even play that card draw spell in a long time because I have other spells I can play, especially now that the Night Arbiter happened. Although I have a lot of tapped lands in the deck. I think I have 8 basic lands and 5 gates here left. Another Griffin. Well, that's... They're playing 4 mana 3 power guys, and I am playing cheaper 3 power guys, so I'm winning this race, but of course those things fly, so I can't block them. Well, that was a sweet one. Yeah, definitely I'm just gonna go and offer the trades here, but... If they block, I'm gonna of course Sentinel's Mark and then Summary Judgment the tapped Griffin. I'm just thinking about what to do if they don't block. I will take 6 here. I think it's still worth it to play the Night Arbiter here rather than start removing them because I have a lot of damage here coming up. I can drop to 11. I can gain life from the Sphinxes inside at some point, but more importantly, I have if they attack with those guys, they will be tapped and summary judgment will be getting rid of one of them with 2 mana, and I also have the option to try to get rid of one of them with the low mage's binding, and I can cast both of these next turn if I so choose. So this thing works so that the creature gets lifelink. It always has vigilance and +1/+2, and then if I cast this on my main phase, then it also has lifelink for that turn, not indefinitely. Okay, so opponent is making a play. Okay, that's a good kind of flying racing, game plan, but unfortunately for them, it's not going to be enough. Now I'm considering here some options. They might even block here, although it's quite unlikely because they are having 9 damage coming up. So I could just Sentinel's Mark in here. I'm gonna definitely summary judgment one of the griffins for sure. I'm just thinking about, do I want to gain life here, or do I want to kind of remove either of the other one too? So if I gain 4 life, I would be at 13. They could attack for 6. I would at 7. But they would also take a lot of damage there. I think this makes the most sense. I get to deal a bit more damage this way too. Let's give this guy a lifelink right now. Yeah. And trading with the Forbidden Spirit, it's not really... I don't care about that. I will steal Summary Judgment there. One of the griffins here. Because now they basically have to deal with the Knight Arbiter, and they have also this 4/4 that might be... I mean, this is of course card disadvantage if they now remove it. I do realize that. But I think I wanted to rather gain the life than attack with these guys and then them not blocking there. And then... I don't know, of course I would have gotten them pretty good if they blocked regardless, but I think the reason they blocked was that I had the lifelink available and they didn't have the win for the next turn. I don't think they would have blocked if I attacked without casting this, and then I guess I still would have killed one of them and played the low mage's binding on other than both of them. But thing is, if they now need 2 removal, because they need to deal with both of these. Of course they can have a good blocker for the officer, but I have a low mage's binding for that, so the Arbiter will be lethal sooner, I mean in a couple of turns, and this of course is something they can't currently even block profitably. So I think that was okay. Okay, that's like, they would have slime binded. Okay, they did that. So let's see, can only cast one spell. I'm gonna play the Griffin in here. So they had life gain 2. Alright. Well, let's play the Griffin here. Let's cry, and next turn I potentially can. How about the Pegasus? I mean, it doesn't work against that, but it does work against the 1/1s. I'm trying to trade with this thing at least. And next turn I can play the Pegasus and one of these spells. So yeah, it makes sense. It's a low impact card, but in this case I think it does make sense. Yeah, the 3 life they gained, that was relevant indeed. And now the Knight Arbiter is not going to be that fast of a clock. They would be at 4 life now otherwise. But yeah, I can of course trade here. Try to trade, and that worked. Now I can double spell. And I will have a blocker for the... Well, that's going to be a low mage's binded then. So this is unblockable. And gonna play the Pegasus, and I'm gonna, just in case they might have some kind of counter spell, I'm gonna do this right away. So if they can answer now the Knight Arbiter, that will be good for them, but if they can't... Well, let's draw the cards first, get some life too. And then I will attack with the Arbiter, no reason to attack with the Pegasus there. And then I can play the Guild Mage. I think I might play the Guild Gate. Yeah, I mean, I still have a land I can loot away, and I'd rather have access to all this mana, I think. And I might also just be interested in. Okay, they had to answer for that thing, so things are in a stalemate right now, so I have to start looting here instead. Well, that is convenient, but of course I do have three of these guys in my deck. Anyway, the point is that they can't attack because I have the Pegasus here. I mean, they can force some damage through. Well, that didn't do much. I mean, they get rid of my looter, but okay. That was a victory. Okay, again a very nice hand here. 2-drop, 3-drop, and so on. And mana to cast them. Opponent did mulligan. And they kept 6. Okay, so this seems good. I get to even go for some damage here. Play the 3-drop. And then next turn I can maybe even loot, although I don't want to lose my 5th land drop because I have this unblockable guy. And I might just attack. I mean, let's say they play something like a 3-3. I might just, you know, for tempo reasons to... Okay. No. Anyway, I'm gonna definitely, rather than loot, I'm gonna attack for 2. I think that's what I wanna do instead. And then whatever they play, if it's something annoying, I can Law Mage's Binding them, and then I have the Azorius. Well, that's gonna be a 3-4, so maybe it's annoying enough. I think it's annoying enough. It's just a nice to deal, you know, another 5 damage and then have the Knight Arbiter in there. I think it makes sense because Knight Arbiter is a serious threat they need to deal with. And if they deal with it, I have still time to, you know, loot for more flyers and Knight Arbiters in here. So that's gonna be okay. That was a concession. I mean, I kind of understand it in a way, because if that was the only card they could play this turn, this is only gonna, even if they use both riots for the counters, it's gonna be a 4-3, so my Forbidden Spirit would still be able to attack, and they would have to either drop to 3 life or have to make the trade. And so maybe that was just something they realized and decided that it's not worth playing here. Well, this is an unexciting hand, but because of how I have the Forbidden Spirit, I should be good here. Even if they have some aggressive start, I can tax one of the turns. They are not gonna be able to attack, so... And it's a 3-3, so it can block by a bunch of guys. That's a good one, though. Okay, they have an aggressive deck. Okay, so I can actually play my tapped land now. I should actually just auto-pass. because I don't want them to realize I have the Arrester seal, although they probably did realize it already. Okay, so this is exactly good now because I can make them be unable to attack. Although I'm not really sure, should I play the Ministrant here instead? And then maybe next turn play the Forbidden Spirit. I think that makes more sense because this has good blocks. I guess if they have the... Yeah, the bad thing here is that they could have the Grotesque Demise. It exiles. So I don't get the tokens in that case. But if they have any other removal... Oh, that is also possible.
Yeah, okay.
Well, I mean, then I'll just have to play the Forbidden Spirit next turn. And at least I will have the Zeal up. So if they have some similar kind of removal, then it means that I can kind of counter it in a sense. But yeah, with the Spear Spewer and the aggressive start they already had, they are definitely a favorite to win here. I have some life gain, but not a lot, so it's gonna be very tough here. Okay, so they can just riot up with that thing, but they didn't riot it, okay. Oh, of course, because why would they? I was talking about haste, but of course they couldn't attack with anyone because of the taxing ability there. Right, so I have to now simply do so that the zeal won't be... I can't leave mana up for it. I have to play my guy here, because this has minis and stuff like that, so... I basically hope they don't have anything too relevant in there. If they do, I'm just losing here, but that's... I mean, they had a good early play here, and the aggressive start, and they had the Scorch Mark on my Ministrant was actually there. That was the key turn when they really were able to go pull ahead, and had I played the Forbidden Spirit, that would have been a completely different situation in that case. At least they don't seem to have a reasonable attack in here, so now I have some options. This will be getting Death Touch though, so that does mean that I'm just gonna play the Giant here, yeah. Get the free attack in. The Giant gives me two blockers because at some point they can just, you know, attack with everyone regardless of the fact that they are gonna lose some of their guys because they can push some damage through, and with the spear, that might just be what they need to do. And I kind of hope that I will find a Sentinel's Mark. I could gain a little bit of life. Or I guess there's the draw 2 that has the gain 2 life clause with addendum, so... But I feel like I need to find life gain here in order to be able to win this game. My clock isn't really that fast. So that's gonna trade with one of my guys. It's gonna be the Forbidden Spirit, of course. I mean, the Arrester's Zeal does one thing, it will make this attack for 5 at some point, because they don't have anything that can block flyers. They had Macabre Mockery they weren't interested in having. Okay, another one of those guys. Well, things are not that desperate necessarily, because I do have the surprise attack with the Flying Giant. But especially if they continue using the Spear Spewer there, that can be... bad for them. Let's see, I don't have a lethal next turn, but I have actually a lethal turn after that. But let's see if they can win, because they can deal a bunch of damage, especially with that thing. Okay, so they might just go for it now. No, they didn't. They made it a bigger guy instead, so... I can deal 9 damage next turn. That's too short. Right. Well, I mean... I can't attack with the Giant, it doesn't have... But am I gonna just lose here? I think I'm gonna lose here, but there's nothing else I can do. If I attack with the Giant... Yeah, I don't have the win there. I mean, I can make this unblockable, and this will be dealing 5, and this will be dealing 4, so... And even if they use the Spear Spewer... No, I just have to do it like this. There's nothing else. And I think, I don't even do the math, but I think it's fairly certain that they're gonna lose winning on the next turn. Don't even play anything here now. Because they can just attack with all. This has menace, this can make one of my guys unable to block. So I'm pretty sure I can't make the blocks in such a way that I would be surviving. But I do have the win for the next turn. I mean, maybe they think that they have one more turn that they want to see what they draw. In theory it's possible, but yeah, it's pretty unlikely scenario. So now I have to just block their biggest guys. There's nothing I can do about it. So they have the spear spewer for one extra damage here too. Yeah, like I said earlier, I'd need probably a bit more. Life, because this is now actually 5 damage and they can deal 6 to me, but so I guess I win if they don't have the one additional damage. But this is the only thing I can do here. This has menace, so this is the most damage I can block. If I put 2 guys in here, I can only, yeah, I would take 6 otherwise. So this is the optimal way to make the blocks. So let's, I guess there's one thing. I don't have to kill the gutter pawns. I can do it like, no, it's actually too stupid me. Both are 2 power, so it doesn't make any difference. Fine, let's do it like this. Okay. That thing has death touch, but that actually, they need to draw something. That's not gonna be good enough, thanks to my zeal I have here. I do have actually lethal attack here if they don't have something to... Wow, I won this game. Arrester's Zeal, super relevant after all. Oh man. I'm at exactly 1 life when all this is over. I mean, if they want to use the Spear Spewer. Well, that was sweet. After that start, when they exiled the Ministrant, things were looking very bad. This was that game, right? I have the Ministrant Exile here. And that was also me ranking up to Diamond. I don't usually play Premier Drafts, but so I don't usually rank higher than Platinum during a month, but now that we have this Ravnica Drafts, I'm playing quite a bit of Premiers. Well, this can be a bit questionable. I am on the draw. If I was on the play, I would happily maybe keep this, but now I have to kind of figure out if this is worth taking the risk. There are, of course, slower decks in this format as well, but if opponent goes like 2-drop, 3-drop, this has only 3 toughness, so this is not even gonna block that well. But I have the double arbiters here. I think I'm gonna keep this and I hope that I draw a 2 or 3 mana spell in a couple of draw steps. Or that the opponent doesn't have like a 2-drop. If they don't have a 2-drop, but they do, that's to be expected. Now that's a 2 mana spell, but not exactly the kind of spell I'm looking for here. So yeah, if they have a 3-drop, I would just lose. And that was the, yeah, like I said. Well, okay, this is good. I think, I mean, this will be a 6-6 before I am able to win, and I can trade with this even if they adapt it. My 4-3 flyer will trade with it, so I think I'm gonna just do it right now, and just because I don't want them to counter it, I'll do it right away. Yeah, they had 2-3-4 start, but at least I did throw the 3 mana removal there, which is good. And now I will play this, of course. And then with the Sentinel's Mark, I can... Well, no, I can't. This is gonna be a 5-5. They can attack with the Skitter Eel. I mean, they can attack with the Ermongolus, but yeah, Skitter Eel should be, because I can't block it, they'll make it a 5-5 if I block it. Now they don't have to, if they have something they want to play instead. But with the Knight Arbiter... Okay. So what do I do in here? This has Vigilance, right? I can make the attack. I suppose I start with that, and I'm not gonna give it lifelink for this turn, because it's not a permanent lifelink. I can get once the lifelinks there. So... It feels like I wanna play the Knight Arbiter instead of this thing, but it's not so clear, actually. No, let's just play another flyer. It has Vigilance, it's gonna be fine. I mean, all this has Vigilance, but the 2-5 doesn't really help against the 5-5 threat in here, so that's the reason I did that. Now, I could double block it. But they can trade with one even without using their adapt ability, and they do have also access to 6 mana thanks to this Gyre Engineer, so they could have 3 mana to adapt it and then deal with. I mean, they can't really deal with this because it costs 2 mana more to cast spells targeting them, but they could have like a bounce, a plus 1. Oh no, they actually would need a plus 3 isn't even enough. I guess if I want to get rid of the eel, I should just do it. Okay. I don't think there's something they could do to deal with it. So now I'm gonna attack with the Sphinx, and if they adapt, I have the chance to Sentinel's Mark it, and that would be pretty nice. I mean, if they block and adapt. Okay, they did not. So that means only that I'm going to... Why didn't they play anything? Oh, do they have a Frilled Mystic? That's so annoying, but I suppose there's not much I can do about it. I'll play my 6 drop. Yeah, that's just... That is just rude. Well, I can still get some value from the Sentinel's Mark in here. This Vigilance is really relevant in this situation. And that's gonna be annoying. I think I would have wanted to get the land to be able to cast the Arbiter and the Sentinel's Mark in here. So now I'm gonna lose to the Sword from Hydrid here. Let's see. At least the Knight Arbiter can block the 3-2. But it would have been so much better to have access to the Sentinel's Mark in here. Okay, that gives all the counter guys a trample. But that means that the Hybrid won't be a 6-6 now. So there is that. So I guess there's a chance. I mean, adapting these will both cost 4 mana, 6 mana, I mean. So that's... They can't make them both larger than that. Oh, they have some... No, they were just doing like that. I mean... Yeah, this is not good. I do want to have the Sentinel's Mark. I'm gonna take the 3 here now. And I'm gonna gain life with the Sentinel's Mark here. Yeah, Yeah, it would be nice to have the arbiter here, but I have to make some calculations now. I mean, I can make myself a win for the next. By the way, I need only one. Oh, if I had drawn like a the formation, what's that? That would have been enough. But now I really can drop them to one life only. Okay, so I can gain 5 life. And attack with both, they have vigilance anyway, so they're at 1 and I'm gonna go to 12 here. They can use this thing. But I suppose I have to Concordia Pegasus. I would have preferred, of course, a land. But, well, they have a thought collapse. Well, that makes them win the game then. Well, that was bad. They had the three. They had the 2 extra mana there available. I don't think I can win anymore. No, because I don't get the life here. Yeah, they are gonna. Everyone with the +1/+1 counter has trample. That's the problem. I can't just jump block here. Yeah. And even if I survive one turn, this is not gonna be a lethal. And this thing won't be surviving here. Yeah, this is gonna be bad. Yeah, the Frilled Mystic was really, I guess. And well, I mean, the Titanic Brawl was the thing they needed there. Yeah, whatever I block here is not gonna work. They're gonna, because this will be have trample. Yep. Well, maybe they adapt the wrong guy or something like that. But no, they didn't. They understand. They will trample. Exact, geez. Well, at least I won't lose rank while I'm bottom of tier 4. Mythic ranked 28. So let's have a good start here. I have a 3 drop. I am on the draw, but I'm gonna keep it. I have the colors here. I can play the 3 drop and the Griffin. And, well, not the Sphinx yet. I need the other blue source for that. Okay, another Simic here. Might just have a bad matchup against Simic, actually. They have the big guys there, so my 2/5s and such are not really very good blockers in the end. Yeah, this is what happens when opponent plays a 2-drop, 3-drop, and they are on the play, and I don't have the 2-drop here. That they are already in a very good shape, but at least they can't attack even if they had some kind of removal here. So, I mean, I suppose if they have a 2 mana removal, they can attack with the Steeple Creeper. It's gonna cost 2 mana per creature. Okay, there's that, and then I'm gonna play my Sphinx here. Yeah, I need something for the Soro form guy here. Alright, so I'm gonna do that block and see what happens. Just a trade. Well, I have vigilance from this guy. Problem is that next turn they can start making this. They can make this a 6/6 and deal a ton of damage. But I think I'll just have to play this. Hopefully they don't have a quench there. If they have a quench, I think I can't. Yeah, okay. That's basically game over, actually. They will attack with both if they have a... Yeah, that was just them tempoing me out. I could have played the Sage Rose Savant, but it doesn't do anything against them. I tried to play these things that I can at least try to raise them. But now, if they have an untapped land, I'm just gonna lose because... Well, that only affects spells, not abilities, so... This was... Okay, that thing does something, but I'm never gonna win the race here. What do I do here? Ton of damage here that they're gonna be able to deal. I guess I'm gonna just scry here and... But yeah, they're at 16. I don't really see how that's gonna work. Next turn I wanna have probably play all these. I can draw one land here. So it's gonna be the Senate Courier, which can block the Chillbringer at least. And then I can try to do something with the Code of Constraints or something. I don't know. Okay, I guess if they don't have the sixth land, it's gonna be... I'm gonna have a chance here. Because they can only attack with the Skitteril. And I'm not gonna block it. I don't wanna lose both of these. If they adapt there. Which they did. So now they will be able to do stuff for the sort of from hybrid too. Anyway, I am going to attack with yeah, I need life gain. I don't have a life gain. I guess I'm gonna just do this. Boost the Savant in here and then attack with these guys. These are both lethal. That's the problem here. Yeah, like I said. That's not good. I mean, I have to jump the Soroform hybrid and I can double block the Skitteril. And then I lose my Sphinx of New Prava. And they are 13. And then I still have this Soroform hybrid to deal with. And then this will be also a 3-5 at some point. Okay, so... Yeah. They had too much good tempo. Especially the Quench in there on turn 4 really made it so that I was so much behind all the game. But I really didn't get a lot of opportunities to pick 2-drops in the draft. Because if I had a 2-drop, for example, in this game, I would have been at a much higher life total currently. Okay, so the opponent is playing around something here. Okay, they don't wanna adapt the hybrid quite yet. Well, this is not the same opponent because they were not mythic ranked. But why I'm playing the same kind of simic deck which has the same kind of stuff here? Yeah, I can't take it, and it has trample as well. So I can trade with I can jump block it, but I don't have enough damage here. That's the problem. I'm simply losing here. I would have to trade with it. And then I have like these more small guys against all that stuff, so it's just gonna be a game over. There's like no way to deal the 13 damage before I'm getting overwhelmed by all those guys. Okay, so a couple of Simic decks. Couple of Simic decks really mopped the floor with me, but that happens sometimes. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next draft video. Bye bye.